welcome to this tutorial. In this tutorial, we will be looking at tool axis control with the use of drive curves. So when it comes to EDGECAM, you have a variety of options that you can use within the 5-axis environment to achieve your results. We will cover a few of these. So as you can see right now on the screen, we have a very basic open cavity part that we would like to machine, and the area we would like to focus on is the floor area of this cavity pocket. So let's turn on the layer. So the surfaces shown in green is the area we will be focusing. When we look at this, a lot of the times we like to machine the floor area to prevent any collision on the side areas on this face, for example, that face. Normal behavior for the day-to-day user is to use the gouge check area within the EDGECAM Advanced 5-axis cycle. So they will probably activate option 1, where you'd like to only focus on the tool area or the carbide area. And then as a user, you would probably then have the option 2, where you would like to tilt the tool automatically, which is the right way of going about to make the calculation for the advanced 5-axis pretty simple and pretty effective. However, sometimes you can get a longer tool calculation due to EDGECAM having to calculate the automatic tilt for you as a user. So sometimes you can look at other options without having to use the collision check to just fasten your process. And it normally gives you a better surface quality as well as control over your tool. So we will look now at the first command. As mentioned in the first command, you can see the toolpath. It looks fine and it should probably be good for machining. Because I haven't calculated the toolpath yet with the check or the gouge check active, I can now go and simulate the tool. We simulate the tool, and as the tool goes into motion, we can see a nice move. However, we get a straight collision through the component. So if I just pause it at that stage where I get that collision move, there we go. We can see the clear collision. And now, by having that collision, this would probably cause a crash. So a lot of times, as a user, you forget to use the gouge check. And then by the time you get to simulation, you will only see that you had a really big collision on your machine. Sometimes guys don't even simulate the tool. They just put the NC code out to the shop floor, and then it's a little too late. So how can we prevent that? We look at the first option, as I've just mentioned, with the gouge check. We simulate the new calculated toolpath where we've enabled the gouge checking. You can now see a lot of leading and lagging on the machine for the gouge check, because you now have to probably go and have a look at leading in and leading out retractions. We have now used the tilted through point with tilt point and tilt angle from a point towards an axis. So when we look at that, the tool point that we have picked was the center point of the curve. So now when we have picked that, the tool will stay in inclination with that point at all times. It's almost like looking at your tool holder or your shank and see it as an extrusion into infinity. And as soon as it hits that point, it creates the tilt motion for you. You can now see the tool stays in contact with the point at all times, which gives you a great control. So it's quite an easy way to go and use tilted motion by either using the point from the tool axis control or as we will follow through with drive curves. So this was the tilted. So for this, we have used the purple curve this time that we have generated to control that tool behavior. Again, as mentioned in the previous command, where we were using a point and the tool goes out into infinity. This now behaves in a similar manner. However, it just uses the full curve or the full length of the curve. So let's simulate this toolpath. You can now see the tool stays in line with that tilt curve that we've created. So we can get a nice and smooth tilting behavior of that tool. So when we look at that in the real world, we did not even use any collision, just by adding in a little bit of user knowledge of using curves and drive curves in the five axis environment of EDGECAM. So in the tool axis control command, we have used tilted through curve, and then from start to end for each contour. That means we're going to use the full length of that drive curve to control the tool, as you've just seen in the simulation. And then if we go just over to the gouge check world, you can see we've not even used any gouge check. So looking at the shorter drive curve, we can see we have got both the short drive curve layer on and just the normal drive curve. So when I look at this drive curve here and I turn it off, you can now see the reduced drive curve. Put it in a better view. You can see there's quite a big difference between the two curves. But let us now look at the toolpath from the shorter drive curve. Simulate that. Tool goes into motion and it hits the curve at all times. Just change maybe the tool to a little bit more of a transparent view, so you can see how that tool is constantly in contact with that short drive curve. And what you get now is a really smooth motion on the tool and on the behavior of how the tool tilts in a really confined space or in a really complex cavity area. But what this also brings is that this will probably give you a better surface finish. It will give you a smoother behavior at your machine. We will now compare the two different drive curves where we've just extracted some wireframe from the component so that we can establish the behavior of how the tool will look. So for the current cycle that we have active is the long drive curve. But take extra note that when we come to simulate this, that you will see some funny behavior in this area due to the overhang of the drive curve on this side of that pocket area that we had. So we can now just quickly over here, you can now see that really bad behavior or bad practice or whichever terminology you as a user would like to use. We do not like to see this behavior. So to prevent that, we've just shortened the drive curve to get a nice and smooth lead in and lead out motion. So if I turn on the shorter drive curve and turn off the longer drive curve, and then just go and re-establish that curve in the cycle and regenerate, you will see a better lead move. So we're just going to pick the new curve, right click and say okay, and straight away you can see there's a better motion on the leading out and the leading in motions. So we simulate that as well. Nice and gentle motion. We're going to go for this toolpath that we've created with the short curve and simulate that to justify the settings we have implemented on this 5-axis toolpath.